I'm with you in Rockland, where we hug and kiss the United States under our bedsheets. The United States that coughs all night and won't let us sleep. I'm with you in Rockland, where we wake up electrified out of the coma by our own souls' airplanes roaring over the roofs. They've come to drop angelic bombs. The hospital illuminates itself. Imaginary walls collapse. Oh, skinny legions run outside. Oh, starry-spangled shock of mercy. The eternal war is here. Oh, victory. Forget your underwear. We're free. I'm with you in Rockland. In my dreams, you walk dripping from a sea journey on the highway across America in tears to the door of my cottage in the western night.
It's a feeling that begins in the pit of the stomach, right? And rises up through the breast, out the mouth and ears, right? And it comes forth as a croon or a groan or a sigh, right? So if you try to put words to that by looking around you and trying to describe what's making you sigh, to sigh in words, you simply articulate what you're feeling.
Understand what angel-headed hipsters burning for the ancient heavenly connection to the starry dynamo in the machinery of night means?
Sir, you can't translate poetry into prose. That's why it is poetry.
What are angel-headed hipsters? Do you think Mr. Ginsburg's work will survive the test of time?
He has no way of knowing. No more than some people thought Leaves of Grass would survive.
I'm asking him for his opinion, to give us an opinion on that book. He says that literary value depends on surviving the test of time. I want to know if it will.
Now, if Luther Nichols could answer that, then the good Lord could use a helper, and he ought to be up there.
How can he tell?
I'm asking for his opinion as an expert.
I'll ask him.